Okay, everybody, it's springtime, and I know you want to be ready for next Christmas, and so let's suppose that you live in a big family, and there are 10 people in your family, and everybody gets white socks for Christmas. Now, the question that you have to ask yourself is, how many socks should you buy this Christmas so that you don't have any socks left next Christmas? So let's suppose we have 10 people in the family. And the half-life of socks is 4 months. And at the end of the year, everybody has one pair of socks. How many socks should you buy at Christmas? Okay, well, this is an exponential decay problem. The number of socks that we'll have at any time t will be the number of socks that we buy at Christmas times 1/2 to the t over half-life. Now, the half-life of a sock is 4 months. I want to measure time in years, so 4 months is 1/3 of a year. So this is time over half-life. Time in years and half-life. I quoted the half-life as 4 months, but 4 months is 1/3 of a year, so the half-life is in 1/3 of a year. Now, if we want to end up with 10 socks at the end of the year, then we want S of T to be 10 pairs of socks. We want to be S to be 10. Then we have our initial number of socks.
Wouldn't it be 20? One pair per 10?
No, I'm just counting pairs.
Oh, okay.
Pairs. So we have 1/2, and then this should be to the 3rd power. Now, I'm going to have to divide through by 1/2. It's going to be a lot more convenient if I write that S0 times 2 to the 3rd. So I get 10 is equal to S0 times 2 to the negative 3. 1/2 is the same as 2 to the minus 1st power, and so if I multiply through by 2 to the 3rd, I see that initially I need to buy 80 pairs of socks, and if I buy 80 pairs of socks for everybody in the family, then everybody will have one pair of socks at the end of the year, which should be plenty.